All right, is it me? It's me. So just throw it up the hill into the basket.
Pretty much.
Flying discs are amazing because
come back.
They fly.
Come back.
They produce lift. Yeah, so the disc going through the air drives some air molecules down, and the momentum of the molecules going down keeps the disc up. If you do it in pressure, yes, there's higher pressure under the disc than on top. But if you've ever seen a paper plate or whatever in the breeze, they do this. So you keep them from doing that, they spin. So the spin provides stability.
Come back.
The amount of torque you get from the spin depends on how much mass. So I'll show you, the rim is a huge part of it. So this is a driver, and you can see, I think visually, that this has more mass away from the middle than this does. This is a putter. The thinner the disc, the more like a knife it'll go through the air, but then it will have, of course, its own flight characteristics. The thicker the disc, keep it low. We tell ourselves that. The more lift it's gonna have, but what do you trade when you have lift? That's right, drag. Kept it low. The putter has more drag, but you're throwing it a shorter distance. The driver has less drag. When the mass is on the side, it's gonna do this. And this is where we call overstable. And this balance between lift, drag, and stability induced by the spin is the dark art of disc golf.